So let's study the differences between ADP and ATP. So the first point under ADP, is, so ADP is also known as adenosine diphosphate, and for ATP we have, ATP is known as adenosine triphosphate. So this was the first point. Now let's move on to the second point. So ADP consists of two phosphate groups, and for ATP, on the other hand, ATP consists of three phosphate groups. So this was the second point. Let's move on to the third point. So the chemical formula of ADP is C10H15N5O10P2, and for ATP we have, the chemical formula of ATP is C10H16N5O13P3. Now let's move on to the structural difference. For ADP we have, so this is the ADP molecule. You can see that we have two phosphate groups. These are the two phosphate groups which are present. This is attached to a ribose, to a 5-carbon ribose, and this is further attached to adenosine. This is the adenosine group. And for ATP we have, so ATP has a similar structure, but instead of two phosphate groups, we have three phosphate groups over here, three groups, and again it is attached to a ribose sugar, which is further attached to adenosine. So these are the structural differences between ADP and ATP. Now let's move on to the fourth point. So the fourth point is on the basis of the molar mass. Molar mass of ADP is 427.2 grams per mole, and for ATP it is, for ATP the molar mass is 507.18 grams per mole. Now let's move on to the fifth point. So the fifth point under ADP is, ADP has lower energy than ATP, and for ATP we have, ATP is a higher energy molecule compared to ADP. So this is an important point. And last we have, so the sixth point under ADP, is, functions include catabolic pathways such as glycolysis, citric acid cycle and oxidative phosphorylation, blood platelet activation, and the role in mitochondria ATP synthase complex. So this is the sixth point under ADP. And under ATP we have, so for ATP we have, functions include metabolism in cells, activation of amino acids, synthesis of macromolecules and active transport of molecules, also maintaining cell structure and contributing to cell signaling. At last, so these were the six differences between ADP and ADP and ATP. I will show a 3D diagram, I will show a 3D structure of these molecules at last, in order to give a clear clarity of these molecules and how they look like. So this is the 3D diagram or 3D structure of the ADP molecule. These are the two phosphate groups. This is the ribose sugar. This is the ribose sugar, and this is the adenosine group. This here is the adenosine group. Same goes for ATP. For ATP we have, so this is the structure of the ATP molecule. You can see that we have three phosphate groups which are attached with the ribose sugar, and this is the adenosine group. Now these are the main differences. We have two phosphate groups for ATP and we have three phosphate groups for ATP molecule. So these were the differences between ADP and ATP. Thank you.